हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ द प्रोफेसर राजकुमार लांडगे फ्रॉम NB नवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सोलापुर। आई हैव वर्किंग इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। आई हैविंग ए 10-year experience in that teaching field. I also completed my M.Tech in electrical power system. Hello friends. In last video lecture, we have to study the output equation of three-phase induction motor and some example related that. So, in that video lecture, we have to discuss about the output equation of synchronous machine. So we already know that what is the synchronous machine, what is the synchronous motor, and their construction and working principle. So in that video lecture, we have to see that output equation of synchronous machine. So output equation of synchronous machine is similar to that of the output equation of three phase induction motor, and that is nothing but KVA is equal to C0 D square LN. So already we have to derive that equation of three phase induction motor. So output equation of synchronous machine, it similar to that of, so how it is similar, just seen that. So output equation of three phase induction motor, KVA is equal to C0 D square LN, call this equation number 1. So in that, C0 is nothing but output coefficient, and that value is 1.11 pi square B average AC KW into 10^-3. So output equation can be work out in terms of peripheral speed in the limiting feature. So What is the peripheral speed? We already defined that, and that value is the, and limit of that value is the 30 meter per second. And that peripheral speed is nothing but, peripheral speed is equal to pi dn. So d is the diameter and n is the speed in RPS. So from that equation, just take the d, and d is equal to peripheral speed divided by pi n. So that value we have to be kept in equation number 1, and equation number 1 is the kVa is equal to c0 d square ln. So in that equation number 1, put the value of d, and equation becomes kVa is equal to c0 into in bracket peripheral speed divided by pi n bracket square ln. Again put the value of c0, that is the output coefficient of, and that value is the 1.11 pi square b average ac kw into 10 raised to minus 3, and peripheral speed in bracket divided by pi n square bracket close ln. So just simplify that equation, and we have to get kVa is equal to 1.11 b average ac kw into 10 raised to minus 3 v square, that is the peripheral speed, divided by n into l. So that is the our equation. So separate that value of d, or selection of diameter d depends upon the following factors. So how the value of d will be decided, or it will be the separated, it will be depends upon the following factor, and that first factor is the type of core used. So what type of the core is used for that, and the second is the permissible speed, permissible peripheral speed. So these are the two factors which diameter d depends. So there are two types of core used for silent poles machines, and that is, the first is the round pole, or it is also called as circular pole, and second is the rectangular pole. So in that first round pole or circular pole, so just look at the diagram. That is the round pole or circular pole, and that round pole are used the ratio of pole arc to pole pitch is between 0.6 to 0.7. So it will be take when you solving the problem. Next is the rectangular pole. So we have to choose the rectangular pole so that ratio of pole arc to pole pitch varying between the 1 to 5 for rectangular poles. But this ratio should not exceed 3 for normal machines. Otherwise, the design of the field system becomes uneconomical. Okay, so that value you have to be used when you solving the problems. Okay, so it is a we already study in the design of DC machine and design of three phase induction motor. Okay, so just we have to be values the different for designing purposes, and that value have to be chosen. Okay, so this is regarding to the output equation of synchronous machines. Okay, so please remember that equation we have to use the when you solving the problems. Okay, so thank you very much.